Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to design buck converter in MATLAB Simulink software. Friends, we know that a buck converter is a DC to DC converter with an output voltage similar than the source voltage or input voltage, as shown here in this animated figure. Due to this reason, a buck converter is sometimes called a step-down converter, since it steps down the source voltage. Consider the figure which shows the circuit diagram of the buck converter. It may be noted that the buck converter may consist of at least two semiconductors such as diode and a transistor, and at least one energy storage element such as capacitor or inductor, or the both two in combination. Let's design this buck converter in MATLAB Simulink software. For this purpose, double click on this Simulink icon to open it. In this window, click on this icon to open a new model. First, we need to save it. You may save it with any name of your choice and in any folder. Look at the figure. To design the buck converter, first we need the DC battery voltage source. To get this, go to Simulink library and go to SimScape, then click on Power System, then click on Specialized Technology, then click on Fundamental Blocks, then click on Electrical Sources. You can see DC voltage source block is available here. Right click on this block and click on Add Block to the model. It will appear in the model. Now double click on this block to put the value. We know that according to data, the input source voltage is 12 volt. Therefore, come to model and put here 12 volt and press OK. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the switching device such as transistor. Therefore, come to model again. Take this MOSFET block from here and bring it in the model. Connect the positive terminal of the battery with the one terminal of the MOSFET block as shown here. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the inductor block. Therefore, come to model again. Take this three-phase series RLC branch from here and bring it in the model. We know that according to data, the value for inductor is 100 microhenry. Therefore, come to model, double click on this block, in the branch type, select inductor and put here 100 microhenry value and press OK. Connect the other terminal of the MOSFET with the positive terminal of the inductor. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the diode. Therefore, come to model again. Take this diode block from here and bring it in the model. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R. Connect one terminal of the diode with the circuit as shown here, whereas second terminal with the negative terminal of the battery. Double click on this diode block and uncheck this show measurement port and press OK. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the capacitor. Furthermore, we know that according to data, the value for capacitor is 100 microfarad. Therefore, come to model again. Copy this inductor block and paste it here. Rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R. Double click on this block. In the branch type, select capacitor. Put here 1000 microfarad value and press OK. Connect positive terminal with the inductor block and negative terminal with the diode terminal as shown here. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the resistor or load. Furthermore, we know that according to data, the value for resistor is 10 ohm. Therefore, come to MATLAB again. Copy this capacitor block and paste it here. Double click on this block. In the branch type, select resistor. Put here 10 ohm value and press OK. Connect the resistor in parallel with capacitor as shown here. Now we need the voltmeter to measure the output voltage. Therefore, take this voltmeter block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it across the resistor as shown here. Now we need the scope to measure the output voltage. Therefore, take this scope block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it with the voltmeter port. Now we need pulse generator block. For this purpose, write this pulse generator in the search and press enter. Take this pulse generator block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it with the gate signal of the MOSFET block. Double click on this block. We have to put the value for time period. To get this value, we know that according to data, it has switching frequency of 25 kHz. Due to this, its time period will be equal to 40 microseconds as calculated here. Furthermore, to get the percentage value of pulse width, we know that according to data, the duty cycle is given as 0.4. The pulse width is equal to the percentage of the duty cycle. Due to this, its percentage will be equal to 40% as shown here. Therefore, come to model. Put here 40 microseconds value. Here 40% value. And press OK. Now we need power GUI block to run the simulation. Therefore, take the power GUI block from here and bring it in the model. Change the simulation time to 1 second. Friends, at this stage, our model is completed. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. Double click on this scope to see the output voltage. You can see it provides the output voltage of around 5 volt. It means that buck converter has successfully reduced the voltage from 12 volt to 5 volt. Friends, in this model, we have discussed the open loop buck converter. In open loop mode, we need the manual tuning of the duty cycle of pulse generator. Therefore, we have to try it again and again to get the accurate results. Another method to get the accurate results is to use closed loop buck converter. In the closed loop system, it is possible to get the output extremely close to the desired output voltage. This closed loop buck converter system is very important topic for the research. Many optimization techniques as well as intelligent techniques can be used on this topic to complete your bachelor degree FYB project. Therefore, I have decided to make many videos on this closed loop buck converter with various intelligent controllers in order to help you. Therefore, don't miss my future videos on this series. For your convenience, I have uploaded this buck converter model in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.